What is up, everybody? Azaro here. Welcome to, finally, my looking back on 2015, looking into 2016. It's my video that I do at the end of the year on New Year's Eve. I'm in my bathroom, as you can see. No, I'm not here taking a dump. It's just that it's too dark outside. It's a funny paradox because when I realized it was New Year's Eve, when I woke up at 12 p.m. I didn't even know, it didn't hit my conscience that it was New Year's Eve. I looked at my computer and it was December 31st. I was like, huh, tomorrow's gonna be January 1st. But then it just hit me, oh damn, New Year's Eve, I gotta do my video now. And as of right now, it is 7:44. You guys can see that we have just under 5 hours for me to do this video. Obviously, this video isn't going to take 5 hours long. Matter of fact, let me do my timer. So that's the reason why I'm in my bathroom now when I'm doing this. So, let's see. I don't want this to be that long. Start the timer right now. So, looking back on this year, just reflecting back on everything, I'm going to be touching on quite a few things. The copyright issues I've been having, the donations, all the troubles and negativity that I'm facing this year, and going into 2016, what do I plan on doing? Because as most of you may know, I am moving to Texas. Hopefully, either it's going to be sometime this January, sometime in January. More than likely, it's going to be then, but if not then, it's going to be early February or something. So I'm planning for another move, and this is going to be like my third move in like a short period, man. It's ridiculous. So, looking back on 2015, man, this year, for me personally, has been a very big roller coaster ride. It started off good with, you know, my YouTube partnership being underway, getting a raise at my 9-to-5, me finding out about GameFly, that way I don't have to spend like $60 and, you know, such things, the games that I wanted to play that you guys wanted to see me play, which I really wish I would have found out about sooner. Moving into this house, which is a negative for me, but I'm going to speak on that later. It's been a roller coaster ride, especially getting into the later months of this year. It's been a big roller coaster ride. That's the one way I can sum it up in just like a short sentence. It's been a roller coaster ride, and it's not one that I'm looking to repeat in 2016. So first off, let me just take the time out to say thank you to everybody that's been subscribed to me since 2006 2007, that have been watching my playthroughs back when I used to do Nintendo DS playthroughs, even till now. Now that I moved on to PC games and PlayStation 4 games and things like that, thank you to all those people who have subscribed to me. Thank you to all those who participated in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Fan Day events and what have you. I can't thank you enough for that. It's been a blast. And as you guys know, in 2016, I do plan on making positive changes on this channel, hopefully for the positive. Because change is always good. My motto is change is always good as long as you don't have to change what's good. And taking everything I learned from this year into perspective, I can most certainly tell you that I'll be applying that in 2016 so that I can, you know, take this channel to the next level. Because this year, regardless of the setbacks that I've had with the copyright claims, even though one of them got cleared up, I'm still battling one, and naturally that copyright claim won't be gone until 2020 unless Arc System Works decide that they want to, you know, lift that one up as well. But yeah, man. This year, you know, we've seen a lot of great things happen with video games and video games like that. There's been a lot of disappointments, such as, you know, the whole major refund done on Steam for Batman Arkham Knight, the disappointments with Metal Gear Solid 5, and several other games this year that just weren't, that didn't live up to the hype, really. Even continuing to play games going into 2016, because there's going to be a lot of DLC content coming out for Black Ops 3. I'm talking about new maps and all that coming out. There's DLC coming out for Fallout 4, a game which I'm still beating the story mode after playing like 50 plus hours of content. It's still so much left to do in that game. The way it's looking, I probably won't beat that game until probably like March, when my copyright, when this last copyright gets cleared up. So they put a lot of content in that game, so I'm happy I played it, and with it being my first Fallout experience, most definitely it's going to be one that I'm going to carry with me into the future. Hopefully they make it a Fallout 5 or something like that. But yeah, that's most definitely been it as far as video games go. This year, I did announce, well, back in January of 2015, this year, I did announce that I plan on doing several things, but because of my living situation, I wasn't able to really get that done, which is one of the things I want to speak on. Most of you know that when I do my commentary here, if you take a notice back in 2014, when I first got here, it was like May 6th, and I was doing my commentary for my videos. I had a lot of isolation from the noise going on around, a lot of solitude, and, you know, I was able to, basically I had a room that wasn't an open area that I have now, you know, so I could close the door and I could ignore all that, and I could do videos without having, or without the chance of, little to no chance of interruption. At the most, you probably hear somebody knocking on the door or something, but other than that, you know, I didn't have those problems. To check this, see if this thing is still going here, because sometimes this digital camera is not the best. But here, I wasn't really afforded that, you know. Ever since late 2014, and for this entire year, actually, you guys can hear my commentary. Every time I had my microphone on, because there's no walls in my room or in the area that I'm sleeping in, because I kind of got assed out and kind of got fucked over when we moved in here. To this day, I'm still against being in this house, but, you know, hopefully moving to Texas can change all that. It will change all that. But being here, it hasn't been the most positive experience for me in terms of me wanting to do certain videos and commentary wise, because anytime I would have my microphone on, I would have to turn it off because somebody's being loud somewhere, somebody's blasting music somewhere, someone's being disruptive to what I'm trying to focus on, and it's a bother when you're trying to concentrate on this, but you have all these distractions in the microphone, and for the viewer, that could be a problem as well, because you're trying to focus on what I'm saying, because it pertains to what's going on in that scene at that moment, and you can't focus on that because somebody's playing music somewhere downstairs being loud as shit, and I can't avoid it without turning my microphone off, and thus I can't do my commentary. So it could have been a funny moment that could have really been something that people could look back on, but because of those nuances, I haven't been able to capitalize on those moments. So it's been something that I didn't even want to deal with, which I knew I was going to have to, so I just dealt with it the best way that I could for the time being, because I knew I wasn't going to be here long anyway. So that was one thing that I had to deal with this year that was very annoying. Also, internet troubles. You guys know that I did start a GoFundMe page, as well as I have a PayPal page, due to the fact that many people have announced that they wanted to donate to help me out with the finances of keeping my internet on, or maybe there's been video games that you guys have wanted to see me play that I haven't really that I couldn't really take the time out to play. But if I was getting donations and, you know, I could see some financial revenue from people wanting me to play that, then maybe I could take the time out to, you know, visit those games and things like that. Because at least that way I still have a way to get my internet and everything on and pay for all these extra games that people want to see me play and whatnot. So going into 2016, even though I'm not going to push it as much, it's not like I was pushing it much anyway this year, but I'm going to keep the donation, I'm going to keep that GoFundMe page going, because I really do need you guys' help. I do need your help with maintaining, you know, this channel. I'm looking forward to more fan interactive things, as well as, you know, series where I ask you guys, what would you like to see me play? What is the most, what is the one game that you wanted to see me play? A lot of people have been saying they want to see me play Bravery Default. They have a sequel to that game coming up soon, sometime next year. I don't know if it already came out or what, but that game, Bravery Default for the Nintendo 3DS, people have been wanting to see me play that. You know, again, donations would come in handy, because that way I can get another Nintendo 3DS that has the capability to do direct capture. That way I can, you know, add my commentary and what have you to the videos, and you guys will be able to see what I'm seeing on my screen and things like that. They have Project Cross Zone 2 coming out next year, which is going to be a big release. You guys know that I played Project Cross Zone one, and I enjoyed the hell out of that game. I played it with my, you know, with my Nintendo 3DS screen like this. It was a very guerrilla style way of recording, and I had it up close like that, and that's how I recorded it at that time during my earlier days, until I found out that there was a way to direct capture, and I found out it was too late for me to get that system. So, and on top of that, I was moving to California, so I didn't really have the financial means to get that Nintendo 3DS system that I wanted to get. So that's something. And then last but not least, these copyright claims. As you guys know also, I think it was, let's see, even though the game came out like late 2014, I think like early 2015, Arc System Works sent me two copyright, well, let me explain it like this. When Guilty Gear XR 3rd came out, I not only did online matches and did like the arcade mode, but I also did the story mode for that game. Like, I played through all the story mode chapters, you know, in both the English and the Japanese versions, voices, due to fan requests. And, you know, it was a pretty good look. You know, people enjoyed the little commentary that I did here and there, to kind of like wrap up each episode. I left the commentary at a minimum because I didn't want to ruin what was actually being shown, you know, in the video. So I didn't want to ruin the dialogue. So I ended up doing that. But then people started sending me messages, whether it was through Twitter, Facebook, or YouTube Messenger, or whatever the case was. Somebody was sending me a message stating that, or they left a YouTube comment stating that, hey, other people are getting copyright claims, and they're losing their channels, and they're getting their videos taken down, etc. So be careful, you might want to remove your videos. So at first I didn't listen to it, because I didn't understand sometimes that's like jealousy from some people. They see your video going viral, so they tell you this to try to like put some fear in you so that you can remove your video. That way your video won't go viral. You know, I've seen situations like that. So at first I didn't acknowledge it, but after a while I thought about it and you're like, you know what? There's a possibility that this could happen. So I just deleted all of my Guilty Gear XR 3 story mode videos, and that was it. A couple days later, I ended up getting two copyright claims from Arc System Works for the videos that I had removed days prior. And I can't remember when I got them. It was sometime earlier, 2015, earlier this year. So it was, it's been a battle ever since trying to get those situations cleared up, because I am in 2016 looking to join a new network. I'm signing a new contract with a new network. I'm playing on it. And I can't do that as long as I have my, these copyrights on my channel. So I've been battling those copyrights ever since. And, you know, one of the copyrights actually got lifted. However, I was never notified of it at all by YouTube or Arc System Works at all. No notification or anything stating that, hey, guess what, this copyright got lifted. You know, I checked my email. I went through, like, days and weeks and months of emails literally trying to find a notification saying that, you know, hey, this copyright got lifted. And I didn't receive any notice of it, so I'm glad it's going, but it would still be nice if they would have told me and I'd have to find out on my own. So I'm still battling one. Like I said, naturally it goes, it gets lifted from my channel on March 20th, 2016, but I'm battling the copyright claims to hopefully get that lifted sooner, because those copyrights are illegitimate. You know, you can't give somebody copyright claims for videos that are no longer on your channel. You know, now, so, because if that wasn't the case, then they wouldn't have got rid of the first one. So I'm still trying to see what happened. Because the whole purpose of me doing this is not only because I have a passion to do it, because I thought about quitting YouTube a million times. Like, I can't tell you, like, every day this year, I just thought about just leaving it alone and going through a regular 9-to-5. You know, what Jim Carrey once said, that if you're going to fail doing something that you don't want to do, why not take a chance doing something that you want to do? And that's basically what inspired me to do this. So I've been doing it ever since. Thinking about quitting YouTube and stop doing video game playthroughs, I'm gonna still share video game footage. Like, it's one of those things that you just can't avoid, especially if you have a deep passion for it. And that's what I do have. And it'll be nice if I could turn this into a full-time occupation. And me getting the news contract just might be the answers that I'm looking for. It just might be the answer to my prayers, you know. So looking at 2016, I'm looking forward to getting rid of this copyright claim and moving on with my life, and that's what I plan on doing. I've spoken several times about creating a new YouTube channel, and that's like, it may or may not happen in 2016. The reason why I said that is because I don't know if I want to sit there and wait for people to migrate from one YouTube channel to the next when I already have it on this channel. I think I may create a new one for like my vlog videos, like my channel updates and things like that, because it does seem like my videos do get lost in the shuffle when, say like if I upload a batch of video game playthrough videos and then I upload a vlog on top of that, it's like people don't see that until, you know, they go dig through the channel and see everything that I'm doing. So that's something that I have to look out for. So if I make a new channel, it would most definitely be separately for my vlog style videos and things like that. Another thing that could just hit me.
How long I got? I'm at 19.
I got like 10 more minutes. But I'm on time. This year, I planned on doing a lot of travels to like Comic Cons and conventions. I did get to go to one, but I didn't get a chance to travel to any others. In Texas, I know they have like a huge convention scene out there, just like they have out here in California. I don't know which one's bigger, but I know it's big in Texas. So I know there's going to be a lot of conventions out there that I can attend and feel myself being at. I may even come back to California to go to come to a convention, because there is a I actually got an invitation. I'm mumbling over my words. I actually got an invitation from AsahiCon, because I signed up for their emails. They invited me to AsahiCon 2016. So I'm looking forward to being a part of that again, because that was a pretty fun convention. Even though they said it was a beginner's convention, I had a lot of fun there. You know, I just wish I had more money on me to buy more stuff, but I plan on making sure I do this time around, because I don't want to miss out on things. So I'm going to be mad when I cut this off, because I know I'm going to think about talking about something else. I might throw an annotation in there if that's the case, but these last 9 minutes and 30 seconds, I'm going to talk about everything that I do plan on looking forward to and what I plan on doing as far as being on this channel. As you guys know, I did later on, earlier in this fourth quarter, I stopped doing the weekly Yu-Gi-Oh! 101 fan days due to the fact that I was focusing on video game playthroughs and me moving to Texas. So I postponed them, the weekly ones, the ones that I would do every Friday, until February 2016. So I still got a month or so before I get started doing those again. Now, this is subject to change, and I could push it back even further, depending on if I have everything set up. So instead of me saying that I'm gonna do it in February 2016, that's just like the earliest I can see myself doing it. But there's a chance that it could get pushed back, so I just want to put that on your mind. So it may get pushed back to like April or, you know, July or something. You know, I don't know. Or June, I don't know when, but at the earliest I could probably see myself bringing it back is in February. That's if everything goes right. So that's that. What else? 2016 is going to be a good time for games. They got a lot of good stuff coming out in 2016. I mean, from Digimon games to, you know, we finally get, but at least from what I can see, the date that they have set for the final video game for Uncharted 4, we got that. We got a new Digimon game coming out. We have Mighty No. 9 coming out, which is Mega Man's successor, made by the creator of Mega Man. You know, and several other games that I'm just really, really looking forward to. A lot of DLC coming out this year. Some good DLC, maybe not a lot, I don't really know. We're getting Dark Souls 3. So, we got that coming out. You know, they're being loud downstairs. That's one of the things I complained about earlier. A lot of other things they have coming out. So, again with that noise, me moving to Texas again is going to afford me the opportunity to have my own closed, you know, room, area, isolation, and solitude that can afford me the opportunity to do the videos that I've been wanting to do. I've been trying to make a new channel trailer, which I just do plan on doing in 2016. I do plan on doing, I think, unboxings on my channel. They aren't done, but it's not going to be for video games anymore per se, because unless I do it with the games that I get from Gamefly, that will be like the only chance. I'll just be revealing the discs. That's all I'll be doing. I guess that would be good to make sure that I don't you know, have any scratched discs or broken discs on my hands, and you guys can see it for yourself. As well as several other things, I still got Yu-Gi-Oh! 101 funnies and retro modernizations that I have coming next year. And I plan on adding like intros to my videos. I don't know how I'm gonna do it, but I'm gonna look into doing that, because I think I need to add some pizzazz to my channel, you know, to try to give it more of a welcoming feel and give you something spectacular to look at when you start the videos. Not every video, but maybe like the vlog style videos. I think it would be good for those. And maybe get a new channel banner that can link to like my Facebook, Twitter, you know, etc. And things such as that. So that's basically it, man. 2016 is looking to be a time of relief and a chance to improve. And, you know, I told myself that back in 2000, earlier this year, that if everything goes right, then I wouldn't need a 9-to-5 anymore. And, you know, things that have not went right. So 2016 is going to be a time for me to recover, getting rid of these copyright claims, moving on to this new partner program to make more money. Hopefully that'll put me in a position where I don't need a 9-to-5 anymore, because working a 9-to-5, it's not really in the best interest of my health, due to the fact that, you know, it's like I walk around a lot and my feet hurt often, and I have lower back problems, and I don't need to be doing, even though I can heavy lift, I shouldn't be doing it, you know. And the crazy thing is, I'm like 27, so it doesn't bother me as much, but I can see in the future how, like, as I'm sitting here right now, there's like a slight pain developing, and like I can't sit for long periods of time without my back hurting and things like that. So I have to like prop up with pillows and things like that just to get some relief. Luckily, I'm not on any medications, and I don't like taking pills. That's not my forte, but that's one thing. But yeah, man, that's just something I'm looking forward to. So next year, I hope to gain more fans, more attention. Hopefully, make some videos that go viral, so that I can finally break through that glass ceiling that I've been trying to break through this year. And with you guys' help, I can do that. So I want to say Happy New Year's to everybody. And this is only the beginning of a fresh start. You know, 2016. Here we come. See you guys then. Thank you guys for watching.